So you reference, there are other players in the ticket business as resellers. There's eBay, there was eBay, and there was Ticketmaster. Can you talk about why you fit a need that they couldn't fulfill? What was different about eBay and what was different about Ticketmaster?
Sure. So I think each one, I think this is an important point for any business that you're going to launch. You have to sort of ask yourself, well, why isn't the big incumbent company doing this? Because if the answer is like they're stupid, that's probably, I wouldn't bank on that necessarily. So we sort of looked at it and said there were structural reasons why eBay and Ticketmaster, the two most logical contestants, were not in this business. And so if you looked at that, start first with Ticketmaster. So Ticketmaster was always in the primary ticketing business. And so that was, I'm just selling a Britney Spears tickets to you. Now we said there were real conflicts of interest if they got in the aftermarket business. So if I walk up to the booth and I say, I want a Britney Spears ticket, and they say, oh, no, I'm sold out in my left pocket, but I can charge you twice as much in my right pocket. I'm going to start thinking, well, hold on a second. How are they shifting tickets around? Do they see me coming? The artist in the venue is going to start thinking, are they trying to sell the original ticket, the after-sale ticket? All kinds of problems. So we believe that was a structural problem. That turned out over time as they tried to enter the business to, in fact, be the case. And they got a lot of crap in the press where they bought a company called Tickets Now and had problems with Bruce Springsteen and all that. Now, eBay, again, was a lot of ways we'd describe our business early on was like an eBay for tickets. So that would beg the question, well, why isn't eBay an eBay for tickets? So eBay works really well for items which are not time sensitive. So by that, I mean, if I had an antique table and I buy it on eBay, if it's chipped or the wrong color, I can get my money out of escrow, give you negative feedback, go get another table next week. That's not a great experience, but that's, manageable. If I want to see the Lakers play the Celtics in Game 7, last summer, and I don't get my ticket on time, it's going to go way beyond escrow and negative feedback. And you can imagine all the problems, or if you're going out with your girlfriend or your wife and it's your anniversary and you have show tickets and they don't work. It has to work. And the reason eBay would not take care of payment and delivery the way we did at StubHub is because they were running thousands of different categories and they had a very vibrant business and they weren't going to change that overall structure for this one category.